Hello everyone, my name is Iris France, 我叫梁婉如。Today we are going to talk about price floor. Definition first, price floor is a legal minimum price at which a good, service, or resource can be sold. Now, if a price floor is lower than the equilibrium price, then it is not binding and it will not affect the market. Using analogy, if the floor is lower than our feet, then we're not going to trip or fall. So a price floor that is lower than equilibrium price, it will not affect the market. Just like our floor being below our feet, then it's not going to affect us. But if the price floor is higher than the equilibrium price, then it is binding and it will create a surplus. Using analogy, if our floor is higher than our feet, then we're going to trip and fall. So now let's take a look at our demand and supply curve. Suppose our equilibrium price and quantity are P star and Q star respectively. And now suppose the government sets a price floor at PF. So suppose this PF price floor is below our equilibrium price. Then you can see that anywhere that is below PF, this gray area will be off limit. So you will be asking, would this affect our market? The answer is no, because our equilibrium price P star is above the price floor, the minimum price. So we're above this gray area, we're okay. Therefore, a price floor below equilibrium price is not binding and will not affect our market. Now I'm going to change the scenario. Suppose again, our equilibrium price and quantity are P star and Q star. But now the price floor, PF, is above P star. So you can see that the price floor is the minimum price that you're selling the good, service, or resource. So anywhere that is below PF will be off limit, meaning your P star is not okay anymore. That's lower than the floor. So you can see that given price PF, our quantity demanded is QD. Our quantity supply is QS. So how do I know that? You can see PF is here. You go to a demand curve to see your quantity demanded. You go to your supply curve to see your quantity supply. And you can see that quantity supply is higher than quantity demanded. And therefore we have a surplus. And therefore, if you have a price floor that is set above equilibrium price, then it is binding and it will create a surplus. Now we're ready to take a look at an example. And we're going to look at agriculture products in the United States. So it started during the Great Depression. And at that time, the prices of agriculture products fell by two-thirds between 1930 and 1933. And very miserably, about half of the loans to farmers went default because the farmers weren't able to pay back their loan because the price of crops was so low. And at that time, the government intervened to help the farmers and set the price floor. So for example, initially the equilibrium price of a crop was say $3 per ton. And the government came in and said that, hey, we need to have a minimum price, say $4 per ton. As a result, there was a surplus for agricultural products. So what the government did was that it used the tax money to purchase the surplus and used its purchased crops to send abroad as a foreign aid. So you can see that typically price floor was set in order to help those sellers, and in this example, farmers. Now to summarize, price floor is the legal minimum price you can charge for a good, a service, or a resource. If the price floor is below the equilibrium price, then it is not binding and it will not affect the market. Just like our floor that's below our feet, it does not affect us and we don't feel them. But if our price floor is above our equilibrium price, then it is binding and it will create a surplus, just like if the floor is above our feet, then we're going to trip and fall and it will cause problems. So this concludes our mini video about price floor. I hope this helps. I'll see you next time.